Tonight, breaking news, the skydiving disaster involving a Navy SEAL. The Memorial Day weekend stunt gone wrong. The SEAL forced to ditch that parachute, then slamming into the Hudson River. Plus, the White House family crisis. President Trump's son-in-law, Jared Kushner, accused of wanting to set up a back channel to speak with Russian officials. This as the investigation into the Trump campaign and possible Russian collusion heats up. Are people close to the president now suggesting Kushner take a leave of absence? Water park emergency. This Trump's return home and shifting developments around son-in-law Jared Kushner's role in a White House under increasing scrutiny. The question facing intelligence and law enforcement officials tonight, what could have motivated Kushner's alleged meeting with the Russian ambassador and talk of setting up a secret back channel of communication? Sources tell ABC News that special counsel Robert Mueller is already working intensively on a sweeping investigation and that he will want to speak with every Trump associate and campaign official who may have communicated with the Russians during the campaign and the transition of power. This amid some strong pushback emerging from European leaders following the president's overseas trip. President Trump calling that trip a home run. Here's ABC's David Wright.
Tonight at the White House, damage control. The president finally back from his first big foreign trip.
I think we hit a home run no matter where we are.
But instead of doing a victory lap, he's circling the wagons. Today, the president's daughter, Ivanka, spotted consulting the private lawyer Trump has retained to handle the Russia investigation. Her husband, Jared Kushner, is the latest administration official to come under scrutiny. He's not a target of the investigation, according to sources, but he does face enough questions that some in the president's inner circle now privately say it might be time for Kushner to consider a leave of absence. First and foremost, why did Kushner try and set up a secret back channel with the Russian ambassador, even after U.S. intelligence agencies concluded that Russia tried to meddle in the election?
I do think there ought to be a review of his security clearance to find out whether he was truthful, whether he was candid. If not, then there's no way he can maintain that kind of a clearance.
The president's allies on Capitol Hill stand by him.
Look, I think Jared has said that he's more than willing to answer any and all questions.
The president's son, Eric, on Fox News last night.
That's all nonsense. I mean, it's a witch hunt. It's really, really insane.
The president himself is clearly frustrated. The Russia story continues to be such a distraction. Today, he railed against the leaks that have been keeping the story front and center. Quote, it is my opinion that many of the leaks coming out of the White House are fabricated lies made up by the fake news media. The president would rather the focus now be on his trip. A great success for America. Hard work, but big results, he tweeted today. At least two of America's allies don't see it that way. Today, German Chancellor Angela Merkel expressed doubts about Britain and the U.S. The times when we could completely count on others are over, she told supporters, a lesson she says she learned in the past few days. The new French president, Emmanuel Macron, who seemed to snub Trump at the G7, dodging right to greet Merkel first, now says his famous white-knuckle handshake with Trump was a moment of truth designed to show he's no pushover. Macron told a French newspaper it wasn't innocent.
And David Wright joins us live now from the White House. David, the president comes home amid all these political problems and now rumblings he may be retooling his press operation?
That's right. Not at all clear if Sean Spicer will be back at the podium in the briefing room. There's talk of getting rid of the briefings altogether. There are even reports that a team of lawyers may start to review the president's tweets before he sends them out into the world, Tom.
A lot going on at the White House tonight. All right, David, thanks so much. We turn now to a freak accident at a brand